episode 9, we got a lot of juicy details that happened in this. Annie's in this damn episode, and Eren is about to take your bitch. All right, everybody, we're going to go right into this. The Gabby evisceration video is running a little bit late, but don't worry, guys, that's coming soon. So we're going to just talk about this episode right now. So first of all, we start off Armin talking on the floor with the seashell in his hand, talking about maybe we could have changed something 3 years ago. Now, if you have the Attack on Titan scent, you would obviously know he's talking to Annie right here. So we come back to 3 years ago. I wanted to see this information so bad. So then we go on to the Marley ships, right? And one of the Marley officers is like, yo, Captain, like, what we doing? We bringing the info back to Marley and shit after we done with this? He's like, yeah. We're going to be done with this just in a minute. So we're going to bring the info back to the ship and then... So then they all fought. They're like, whoa, what's going on? He's like, yeah, it's probably a big wave or something, right? Yeah, it's probably a wave. We'll just get back in.
It's the devil!
Eren is probably so... No, everybody on Paradise is probably so used to be calling devils already.
So Eren's like, here's your pit stop, buddy.
And then Hange's like, welcome to Paradise Island. Let's be friends. So then one of the Marleyan soldiers is like, yeah, I'm gonna trust a random bitch. No. By the way, Hange already knew this dude from the Marleyan ships already. So back to the action, that Marleyan soldier dude, he's like,
bro, you're literally my enemy. Why am I not gonna shoot you?
And Hange's like, do me a little favor. Turn around for me real quick.
He's like, okay, I don't know why you want me to turn around, but...
Like, well played, but I'm still killing each and every single one of them.
We got my son, and I guess my daughter, and then they're like, yo, we about to pull this Glock if you don't listen to us, bro.
And they're like, man, it's an honor to receive your invitation, man.
Man, I'm so excited to see you, Eren.
And then Aaron's like, I have fans.
So right after somebody gets shot, Sasha's going off to sleep, and Amika's like, if you don't wake your ass up.
So Armin's basically happy that we were able to gain information from those two people that were on the Marley ship, and is not fucking with Marley.
And then look, Eren grows his hair out a little bit, doesn't know what to ask. He's sitting there like, yeah, we get to get a lot of information in them indeed. The only thing is, if Marley starts attacking, that's gonna get hectic.
Then Hange's like, I know how to escape all of the Titan shit. I'm gonna kill myself.
Nah, she was just learning how to use the guns from Marley. But basically, we're at the dinner table with those two people that betrayed Marley, right? So they're basically just explaining what Marley did, what their plans were, and stuff like that.
So Blanchek over here says, each Marleyan army division has about 20,000 soldiers, and there's about 50 divisions. Doing the math, 20,000 times 50 is a million. So yes, Marley had over a million soldiers. And whoa, not even done yet. They also have 21 battleships, and they have new weapons that they're making, and they have aerial military capabilities, probably like the blimps and shit, which they never had in Parody.
So then Hange's like, none.
And then Levi's like, Hange, don't act surprised. You're gonna think that we're puss baskets.
And then Hange's like, I know.
So basically, they were talking about what they did on Paradise for the rest of the time. And then Levi didn't want to tell them all the information because obviously I wouldn't trust them either. But then obviously, you know, in the future, they end up cooperating. So if you're wondering why these two betrayed Marley, it's because they both lost their homes due to Marley and they got forced into military combat because of Marley. So they're basically like, fuck Marley. Blanchek says she lost all hope until she saw the Beast Titan in action, saving everyone and kicking ass. She likes Zeke so much that she was sitting there on the table having an orgasm about Zeke. She's like,
ah, beast dick.
But another thing gets revealed, if you're wondering why Blanchek shot that soldier, it's because they were under Zeke's orders. So this dude Zeke, he know what he's doing, bro.
So peep how long Zeke was already setting shit up to be on Paradise's side, or Parody, I know. So these two are basically anti-Marleyan volunteers.
So then it's been a while since we've seen this story on her royal ass.
In this court thing, they're discussing what plan are they gonna do to take action, right? So it is revealed in Zeke's letters that a Titan with royal blood, if he touches a founding Titan's hands, they are able to control all the Titans, right? So then basically, yeah, are you having flashbacks to season 3?
He already got the memories in season 3, so he already knew all this stuff, but this is how the whole world, or not the whole world, I guess this court case, found out about it because of Zeke's letter. So they were like, is Zeke lying? But Eren knows he's telling the truth because obviously he just got the memory.
So then we get the flashback of when Eren did it. Look at wit.
So then basically Levi's like, why the fuck did you not tell us this entire time, Eren?
And then Eren's like, it's because I love Historia. And then Historia's like, oh,
he loves me.
And then Mikasa killed Historia, and that's how the episode ended. I'm joking.
So basically Eren's like, the only way I can see hope is if we activate the rumbling, which is all the millions of colossal titans in the walls, and just send them to just destroy the damn world, basically. So the only way to have peace is destruction? So over here, there's still more Marleyan boats coming along from the ship. And then, you know, Blanchek and the other dude, they're actually on the Eldian side, so they're actually tricking the real Marleyans of the ship. They're like,
hey, don't worry, we're coming for you. We're gonna save you, bro.
And then...
they're like, wait, what the... colossal titan bear toad, is that you?
And then Levi's like, welcome to Devil Island, where we have glocks and we threaten people. Now do what we say, because you're surrounded, and you're not going to make it out alive if you don't cooperate.
Damn, Levi, how you call somebody pig piss?
See, shout out to the Attack on Titan being the ghost putting black people in the show.
Sasha's like, why is your skin so dark? And he's like, can't you see? It's because I'm black.
He's like, nah, it's actually because God made us that way, bro.
God is the reason why the Ymir got his power, right?
God is the explanation. And they're like, nani?
So this Marleyan dude, you know, that you're getting used to, he just cooked them a little food, right? And they're like, man, should we eat this food? Is it good? And then Sasha took a bite out of that bitch and she did not stop. This dude over here is like, man, you're eating so sloppy, man. Where's your manners at? You know what? I kind of dig sloppy bitches.
So during this time period, you can see that the Marleyans are seeing that not all Eldians are bad, obviously. And the Eldians are seeing that all Marleyans aren't bad either.
You see they're cooperating together.
That could be the whole solution to this whole shit.
Eren is over here preparing for Fortnite chapter whatever it's on. And then we got the squad just chit-chatting. And then Eren is like, have you seen Bertolt's memories? He's like, not anything important. I kind of saw him use the bathroom a couple times.
So by that point, Zeke only had 3 years left to live. So that's how much time they need to, you know, cooperate with Zeke. Right now, he only has one.
But they're like, should we really follow Yelena, the blonde chick's plan?
Should we really trust
him? Armin actually brings up a good point. He's like, is threatening the world with all the colossal titans really a good idea? We're just gonna seem like yard devils. And then Eren's like, I don't give a fuck. We're monsters that can turn into titans, so be it. But Eren's basically a bad boy now. He's a savage right now. And then as Eren shoots the gun, they got this fantastic transition into Sasha dying, right? But I'm like, I'm wondering if Eren can see, you know, some parts of the future, like how maybe the attack titan power, he could probably see some parts of the future. And you know, I don't know, maybe he saw Sasha his death because he didn't really have a reaction. I don't know. I'm just throwing predictions out there. Maybe he could. I'm really thinking he can.
So this happened during a damn funeral. It's funny how the tables turn.
This Eldian dude is like, you're a Marleyan? What are you doing here, stupid bitch?
It's funny how the tables are turned, because if we go back to the outside world, it's basically the same thing happening, but in reverse.
So basically, this dude that kind of like Sasha, I'm assuming, met her parents. He's like, yo, I can cook for you anytime. And he's like, yo, I got your respect, buddy.
So basically, Levi still doesn't even like Zeke.
Zeke said the reports on the newspaper said we're successful. And then Levi's like, you know what else could be successful? If I kill you, send your body to Marley and say that you are working with us. That would be a success for me, because I get to fight you either way, bitch.
Zeke's like, all right, calm down. Can I at least see Eren first?
He's like, I'm the captain. You do what I say, you little bitch. And he's like, I'm going to send you to a 5-star hotel.
This dude, Levi, said, I'm going to send you to a hotel. Watch where you see where you sent him.
Zeke's like, oh, so where's the hotel? He's like, this is your home. He's like,
Nani.
He's like, man, it'd be good to use ODM gears here, huh? Man, can I get Gabby and Falco to know? Honestly, I think Zeke and Levi might fight here. If you look in the trailer, they're in the forest and they're fighting with a bunch of trees. I feel like this is where it might go down right here. I don't even know. So we see Gabby and Falco in there. Falco's just chilling, right?
Guys, take a guess what Gabby said.
She needs to get through her head that she will not kill Eren ever in her life.
And before that's how the show ends, Gabby kills Eren, I would be.
So basically, this is the end game right here. Armin is telling Annie that we basically have no choice but to like attack like you guys did.
So we're basically, you know, in the same positioning as you guys. And then
Armin is also having second thoughts about Eren because of the way he's acting and stuff. He's acting pretty weird, and I definitely agree with him. And Mika says, like, if we win, we survive. If we lose, we die. So this is definitely just big endgame here. So we're getting to see all three of them. And then we transition to Eren. And Eren, yet, he's a lot different, you know. He's still kind of the same with his hot-ass breath. He's basically saying, fight, fight, fight. That's the only way we can win, basically, you know, like back in the day.
Episode 10 doesn't really show much because, you know, Attack on Titan doesn't really spoil, unlike their damn fan base. But my final prediction is that this is going to be the little bit of peace that we have before the whole world comes to attack the Eldians. And number two, Levi and Zeke.
I feel like Zeke is on some mastermind plan, not to help Eldian, but himself. I don't know.
He's probably on some
mastermind plan of Eren, but I don't even know, guys. So don't even really like Eren. Those are my bold predictions at the end. Don't forget to do like us. Don't forget to subscribe. Follow the Instagram. I'll see you guys in another video. Peace.